Hello students, welcome back to another English grammar lesson. Today I'm going to talk about sentence structures. Sentence structures. Under the topic sentence structures, I'm going to talk about verb patterns. Verb patterns or sentence patterns. Sentence patterns. Usually in English language there is a common pattern that we used to make sentences. ඉංග්‍රීසි භාෂාව සාමාන්‍යයෙන් පාවිච්චි කරන sentence pattern එකක් තියෙනවා. Common pattern එකක් තියෙනවා. What is the common pattern? What is common sentence pattern that we use in English language to make sentences? Right. I will show you that. This is the common pattern. In this common pattern, first we use the subject. First we use the subject. After subject, we use the verb. After subject, we use the verb. After the verb, we use the object. So this is the common pattern that we use in English language to make sentences. Now today, I am going to show you some different patterns used in English language to make sentences. Right. Let's see now. Look at the pattern 1. Look at the pattern 1. In this pattern 1, we use the subject first. As usual, සාමාන්‍යයෙන් දීලා subject එක පාවිච්චි කරනවා මුලින්. So after the subject, we use the verb. After subject, we use the verb. After the verb, we use the indirect object. Indirect object. After the indirect object, we use the direct object. That means in this pattern, there are two objects. What are the two objects? Indirect object and the direct object. Right. Now, I am going to give you some examples used in this pattern 1. Sentence number 1. I lent her my pen. In this sentence, I is the subject, lent is the verb, her is the indirect object, my pen is the direct object. Now look at sentence number 2. Teacher gave us homework. In this one, teacher is the subject, gave is the verb, us is the indirect object, homework is the direct object. Sentence 3. We paid him the money. In this one, we is the subject, paid is the verb, him is the indirect object, the money is the direct object. Now look at the example number 4. The thief told us the truth. In this one, the thief is the subject, told is the verb, us is the indirect object, the truth is the direct object. Now look at the next example. Example number 5. The policeman told us the way. In this sentence, the policeman is the subject, showed is the verb, us is the indirect object, the way is the direct object. Right. So this is the pattern 1 that we can use to make sentences. Right. Now I'm going to an activity. Right. Now you have to make sentences according to the pattern 1. Now I am giving you only the words here. The words are mixed up. You have to find the subject, you have to find the verb, you have to find the direct object, and you have to find the indirect object and make the sentence. Right. Let's see the first one. A watch my sister I bought. These are the words. Now according to the pattern, you have to make the sentence. Right. What is the subject of this word? Right. I. What is the verb? Yes. Bought. What is the indirect object? I bought my sister. Yes. What is the direct object? Yes. A watch. Now what is the complete sentence? I bought my sister a watch. Right. Now look at the second one. The police, you, the truth, must tell. The police, you, the truth, must tell. Right. Now, what is the subject of this word? The subject is you. Verb must tell. You must tell the police the truth. You must tell the police the truth. Right. Next one. Number three. A present my father gave me. A present my father gave me. Subject, my father. Verb, gave. My father gave me a present. My father gave me a present. That is the correct sentence. Look at next one. Number four. An answer she gave me. An answer she gave me. The subject is she. Verb, gave. She gave me an answer. She gave me an answer. Next one. Number five. Followed we footsteps her. Followed we footsteps her. Subject, we. Verb, followed. We followed her footsteps. Api ayage adipare gaman. Number six. A letter sent me she. A letter sent me she. The subject is she. Verb sent. She sent me a letter. She sent me a letter. Look at next one. Number seven. They us arranged a vehicle. They us arranged a vehicle. Subject is they. Verb arranged. Past tense. They arranged us a vehicle. Om Sudanam Karapata Vahane. Right, good. Look at the next one. Number eight. Many sweets father brought us. Many sweets father brought us. What is the subject? The subject is father. What is the verb? Brought. Raginava. Past tense. Father brought us many sweets. Right, very good. Now, I am going to show you the pattern 2. Pattern 2. In the pattern 2, we have to use the subject first, as usual. Samana Parima, subject take anna murad. After subject, use the verb. After subject, we have used the verb. After the verb, you have to use a noun or a pronoun. Noun or a pronoun. After the noun or the pronoun, you have to use an adjective. So, this is the pattern 2. Subject, verb, noun or a pronoun. An adjective. Right. Look at the examples. Example number one. The boy pushed the door open. The boy pushed the door open. The boy is the subject. Pushed is the verb. The door is the noun. Open is the adjective. The boy pushed the door open. Number two. She washed the plates clean. She is the subject. Washed is the verb. The plates is the noun. Clean is the adjective. They washed the plates clean. On pidam soda prasidu kala. It is simple past tense. Number three. We found the box empty. We found the box empty. We is the subject. Found is the verb. The box is the noun. Empty is the adjective. We found the box empty. Example number four. The thief broke the door open. The thief broke the door open. The thief is the subject. Broke is the verb. The door is the noun. Open is the adjective. The thief broke the door open. Hora dora kada viurta kala. That is the meaning of the sentence. Right. That is the pattern two. Now I am going to give you an activity. You have to make sentences now according to the pattern 2. Right. I am giving you the words. Right. First set of words. The car fast he drove. The car fast he drove. So these are the words. Now you have to start the subject. It is subject. He drove the car fast. He subject drove verb. He drove the car. Noun fast is adding to. He drove the car fast. वो पहले हुआ कार के वेग है. सेंटेंस नंबर टू. रेड पेंटेड दे द हाउस. रेड पेंटेड दे द हाउस. सब्जेक्ट दे वर्ब पेंटेड. दे पेंटेड द हाउस रेड. ओ निवसे रतुपाट आलेप कला. दैट द मीनिंग. लुक एट नंबर थ्री. वी द कबर्ड फाउंड एम्प्टी. वी द कबर्ड फाउंड एम्प्टी. सब्जेक्ट वी verb found. We found the cupboard empty. Yes, good. Look at next one, number four. My coffee I strong like. Subject is I. Verb like. I like my coffee strong. I like my coffee strong. Yes, let's go to next one, number five. Your shirt you dirty have made. Your shirt you dirty have made. What is the subject of the sentence? Subject is you. What is the verb? Have made. You have made. What is the noun or pronoun? Yes. You have made your shirt dirty. You have made your shirt dirty. Next one. Number six. Open he the room has left. Open he the room has left. Subject yes he. Verb yes has left. He has left the room open. Oh kamare yurta karadama tibenawa. He has left the room open. Right. Next one, number seven. Open we kept the gate. Subject is yes we. Verb yes kept. We kept. Noun the gate. We kept the gate. Adjective open. We kept the gate open. Api gate to a viewtakara tabula. Right, very good. Now I am coming to the pattern 3. Pattern 3. In this pattern 3, as usual, samanyada we have to start with the subject. Subject. After the subject, we had used the verb. After the verb, we had used the gerund. Gerund means an ing form. Verb in ing form. Okay, subject, verb and gerund. Let's see some examples. Example number one. She began singing. She began singing. She is the subject. Began is the verb. Simple past tense. Singing is the gerund. She began singing means a sindu kiyanna patanga. She began singing. Second example. He has finished talking. He, subject, has finished. Verb, present perfect tense. Talking, gerund. He has finished talking. O avasan kara tiyenawa katha kirima. Katha kirima kiyana arthaya thamai gerund eke. Next one. Number three, Mr. Pereira loves teaching. Mr. Pereira loves teaching. Mr. Pereira subject, loves is the verb, teaching is the gerund. Again, remember, Mr. Pereira loves teaching. Right. Look at next one, number four. My brother enjoys drawing. My brother enjoys drawing. My brother subject, enjoys verb, simple present tense. Drawing is the gerund, ing form. My brother enjoys drawing. Right. Now look at example number five. We started cleaning. We started cleaning. Subject we. Started verb. Cleaning gerund. We started cleaning. Simple past tense. Api prisidu kirima aramba kara. Cleaning means prisidu kirima gerund. Right. Now these are the examples for pattern three. Okay. Now I'm going to give you an activity. You have to make sentences with the following words. Okay, these are the words. Teachers correcting papers started. Now you have to join these words according to the pattern. What is subject? Yes, teachers. Verb started. Gerund correcting papers. Now the sentence is teachers started correcting papers. Guru aarambha kara. Prashna Patra, Berlin. Number two. listening to music he loves. Yes, very easy. Subject he, verb loves. He loves listening to music. Number three, people we criticizing, people hate. What is subject? Yes, subject is we. Verb hate. We hate. Gerund criticizing people. We hate criticizing people. There's an extra word here. We hate criticizing people. That is the sentence. Right. Next one. Number four. Reading the book finished he. What is subject? Subject is he. Verb finished. He finished reading the book. He finished reading the book. Next one. Number five. Stop. He liquor taking. Stop. He liquor taking. Subject is he. Verb stop. He stopped taking liquor. Not liquor taking. Taking liquor. He stopped liquor. He stopped taking liquor. Next one. Number six. Drinking coffee my father prefers. Drinking coffee my father prefers. Prefers means very kamata dhatvana. So subject is my father. Verb is prefers. Gerund is drinking coffee. So the sentence is my father prefers drinking coffee. Right. Look at the next one. Number seven. She making mistakes avoided. Subject is she. Verb is avoided. Gerund is making mistakes. So the sentence is she avoided making mistakes. Aya varadikirima magharava tatta. That is the meaning of the sentence. Right. Very good. Now, number eight. Giving false information admitted he. Giving false information. Varitaratu lavadima. Admitted he. The subject is he. Verb is admitted. He admitted. Ubaragatta. He admitted giving false information. Atau biligatta. Ubiligatta varitaratu lavadima. He admitted giving false information. Right. Very good. Now I am coming to the pattern 4. Pattern 4. Right. Look at this pattern. Subject. First we have used subject as usual. Subject. After the subject we have used the verb. After the verb we have used a noun or a pronoun. And after the noun or the pronoun we have used a present participle. Present participle means ing form. Like the gerund. Like the gerund. Present participle. Subject, verb, noun, no pronoun, and present participle. I will show you some examples, first of all. Right, look at this one. I saw him dancing. I saw him dancing. Mama dakka ohu natami ninnawa. That is me. I subject. So verb, him is the pronoun, dancing is the present participle. Right, look at the second example. We smell something burning. We smell something burning. We subject. Smell verb. Something is the noun. Burning is the present participle. We smell something burning. Apita danenama yamak. Delimitibena. That's the meaning of the sentence. Number three. We found them playing. We found them playing. We is the subject. Found is the verb. Them is the pronoun. Playing is the present participle. So we found them playing. Api dakka own sellam karani inna. That is the meaning of the sentence. Right. Look at the example number four. She caught him stealing. She caught him stealing. She subject caught verb simple past tense. Him pronoun stealing is the present participle. What is the meaning of the sentence now? She caught him stealing. Ayat ohu sorakam karaddi mahuna. Sorakam karami sitidi mahuna. That is the meaning. She caught him stealing. Right. Now look at example number 5. Mother observed us playing. Mother observed us pray. Mother is the subject. Observed is the verb. Us is the pronoun. Played is the present participle. What is the meaning of the sentence? Amma balagina sitiya api sellam karamin innawa. Mother observed us play. Very good. Now that is the pattern number 4. Now I am going to give you an activity according to the pattern number 4. You have to make sentences using these words according to the pattern number 4. Right. These are the words. Police, them, hiding, found in the jungle. Subject is police. Verb found. Police found. Pronoun them. Police found them hiding in the jungle. Police found them hiding in the jungle. Policia swarada taun kalaye sangavimin sinna. That's the meaning of the sentence. Look at number 2. Studying, the teacher observed them. Studying, the teacher observed them. What is subject? Yes, subject is the teacher. Verb, observe. The teacher observed. Pronoun, them. The teacher observed them. Study. Teacher, balagina sitiya own padam karami sitinawa. Teacher observed them. Study. Good. Look at number 3. The water they running left from the tap. The water they running left from the tap. Yes. Can you make this sentence? What is subject? Subject is they. Verb left. They left. They left. They left the water running from the tap. They left the water running from the tap. Own tap එක වතුර ගලන්න විවෘත කර දමා ගියා. That means. Right. Now look at next one, number 4. Calling my name, heard I in the morning. Calling my name, heard I in the morning. Can you make this sentence? What is subject? Yes, the subject is I. What the verb? Yes, verb is heard. I heard. Pronoun? My name. I heard my name calling in the morning. Yes, I heard my name calling in the morning. මට ඇහුණා මගේ නම කතා කරනවා උදේ. That means. Right. Now look at the next one. Number 5. Term. Sorry. Then cleaning we saw the house. Then cleaning we saw the house. Subject is we. Verb saw. We saw. Pronoun them. We saw them cleaning the house. We saw them cleaning the house. That is the correct sentence. Abhi dakka oun nivasa pirisidu karamin innawa. That is the meaning. Right. Look at next one. Number 6. Shaking. Shaking. She. The building. Felt. In the earthquake. In the earthquake. What is the subject? Yes, the subject is she. What is the verb? Yes, verb is felt. Denuna. She felt the building. That is the noun. She felt the building shaking in the earthquake. Bhumi kampa vedi ayada denuna godanagilla selavin tibenawa. Selavin tibena. Right. Now you all learn 4 sentence patterns with the examples and with the activities. Right? Next one, number 7, there's another sentence. Heard we him playing the guitar. Heard we him playing the guitar. Can you make this sentence? What is subject? Yes, subject is we. What is the verb? Yes, the verb is heard. Aruna. We heard. Pronoun him. We heard him playing the guitar. අපි දැනුණා ඔහු ගිටාරය වයමින් සිටිනවා. Okay, very good. So, you all learn now 4 sentence patterns used in the English language. Right? I hope to meet you again in another English grammar lesson very soon. Until then, goodbye everybody.